In this video, you'll learn best practices for configuring record events in your apps to track what happens and when. To get hands-on practice with these concepts and other tips and tricks for record types, take the course Explore Practices with Record Types on Academy Online and complete the exercises in each lesson. First, let's start with which record type to configure record events on. My order fulfillment app has various record types: order, order status, order detail, customer, and document. You should use record events with record types that represent major business processes and concepts. That would be order, order detail, and customer. Order events would show you when an order is submitted, shipped, and delivered. Order detail gives a more granular look at when an item is picked from inventory and packed. Typically, you won't need to configure record events for lookup record types like order status or document. This data doesn't change often, and it doesn't give insights into a business process. Remember, you can either use existing record types that you've already been using to track events or generate new ones. Regardless, for each record type that you want events for, you'll need an event history record type that contains the events, and an event type record type that is a lookup for the different types of events. When you generate record events, you'll also be able to easily include comments and replies so business users can collaborate on activity logs. This leads us to what events to capture. You should track events that are main steps in business processes. Events should occur once and in a specific order. For example, an order is created once, then it's packed, shipped, and finally delivered. Then it could be returned, a refund issued, or replacement sent. On the other hand, you should avoid using status changes as event names, such as in progress or closed. Rather, the status changes based on the event. Once an order is delivered, its status is closed. Also, it can be easy to track more events than needed. Think about what would give you insight into your processes. For example, separate events for an order being created and it being assigned wouldn't be necessary. The order assignment is part of the order creation, so you'd only need an order created event. When you're generating record events, you can consider whether to include ad hoc events like updated and commented on. These types of events can happen multiple times and at any point in the process. They'll give you more insight for the activity log, and business users will be able to collaborate with top-level comments. However, you should exclude ad hoc events from your process insights because they don't help you analyze how your process is doing. Next, naming conventions for events. When configuring your events, they should be written in past tense and focus on the activity that happens. For example, use shipped order rather than shipping or shipped order by warehouse 5. If you need to collect information about the event, like the warehouse name, you can add fields to the event history record type. You can simply update the data model to collect more data than is included in the generated record type. Finally, let's talk about when to write events in a process model. Let's say I have a process model for a new order submission, and a path where the order needs to be reviewed by a supervisor if it's above a certain dollar amount. In a Write Records node, it's easy to write events along with your record data. The data should be written immediately after the event occurs. Write the submitted order event after the order is created, and write the reviewed order event after the supervisor approval node. With these tips in mind, you'll have comprehensive event data that you can use to display in activity logs and even investigate further to improve business processes.